Hello guys, my name is X1Gamer and final card reveal for Saviors of Uldum just finished, and I'm sit down now and start revealing cards one by one. So take a drink, even if you wash, if you wish, lay down on your bed, open your laptop or your phone or your tablet. Relax and enjoy, because this will be a little bit longer video than usual, because there is a lots of new cards that was revealed. Some of them is pretty crazy and interesting one. The other one is just a pack fillers like usual, but that's something that you should expect from this batch final reviews. So let's go directly into the card review and start. It starts, yes. Thank you, Timon. You always helping me, my little fella. So let's start with Hunter cards. So we start with Hunter one. We have Swarm of Locusts here. Summon 7/1/1 Locusts with Rush. So this card is pretty good, I say, because it's a 6 mana summon 7 minions, which is 6 mana 7/7 divided by 7 bodies, so it's basically like Unleash the Hounds, but maybe it's a little bit better because it's not conditional, so it's you will always summon 7 bodies. So how good is this? Pretty good. Definitely a 3 star card for me, so yeah, I think it's pretty nice one. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have Unusual Unseal the Vault. This is the quest for Hunter here. Quest summon 20 minions reward. Aramkahan Roar. So what is Aramkahan Roar? So this is Aramkahan Roar. Aramkahan Roar, your hero powers give your minions +2 attack. So in Hearthstone reveal stream, we see pretty interesting card game, but let's be realistic, this was not meta decks, this was not decks that is played today. So I think this quest is awful, and I don't think this will ever see any play in this meta, because today we have a lot more stronger Hunter than this one. And reward is just give your minions +2 attack. Yes, the effect is stacking, so it's just forever. It will never it's not just for this term. The stacking effect is it's forever one. But let's be realistic here. How consistent you will actually can summon 20 minions. So this is not very easy to do. It's not very easy thing to do, by the way, because so how you see, you need to summon a lot of minions, so which means that you need to play a lot of small crappy minions, like example for 1/1 and stuff like this, like the previous card, and Unleash the Hounds. So yeah, I think this card, the quest card, excuse me, let me just return to the quest card. The quest card, I think it's a pretty nice one, but it's nothing too spectacular. So I think this card is a 2-star card. We'll probably see some play in the beginning of the meta, but this will never be the card that will dominate the meta, let's say. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have a interesting druid card, which have a lot of synergy with the quests. 2/1/4 Crystal Merchant. If you have an unspent mana at the end of your turn, draw a card. So it's a pretty nice, interesting 2-drop, but The stat is kind of bad. It's have 4 attack, yes, but it's have only 1 attack. I think this is a 2-star card. Outside of the quest, this will never see any play whatsoever. I want to be very short with this card, so let's move to the next one. Next one, we have Wazy's Surger. 5 mana, 3-3. Rush, choose one, gain +2/+2, or summon a copy of this minion. So this is a pretty nice one. It's very similar to Militia Commander for Warrior, but the good side is that it didn't lose the 3 attack because it's not a battle cry. So it didn't lose the 1 attack, so it's a very flexible one. I think this card is pretty one, even if it's played outside of the quest. If you play this card alongside the quest, which is the Druid quest, is combine choose one into one, which means that for 5 mana you will summon 2/5/5 with Rush, which is absolutely ridiculous and insane in my opinion, because you will take a lot of tempo, you probably win the board and probably will start winning the game from this point on. This is a 4-star card for me because it's a very good solo card, even played outside of the quest of Druid, so I give this card 4-star. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have 1 mana Druid spell Worthy Expedition. Discover a choose 1 card. It's a pretty mediocre to me. You lose tempo if you play this on round 1 and you discover a choose 1 card. Choose 1 card is probably, typically it's a pretty good one, but do you want to play 1 mana to discover 1? Maybe, but I don't think this will see much of play outside of Quest Druid, so I think this card is a 2-star card, but maybe will be a 3-star card next rotation when there is a lot less card for Druid. So it's a pretty one nice card. So yeah, it will definitely see some play because it's very similar to one old card from League of Explorer that was cost 1 mana and you choose to discover a minion or spell. I forgot the name of the card, but anyway, so let's move to the next one. Next one, we have a mage minion. 3 mana, 3-3. Dune Sculptor. After you cast a spell, add a random mage minion to your hand. So this is pretty similar to Cyclone. To mana Cyclone. So yeah, when you put this in your deck with cheap spells, you can generate a lot of minions. And it's mage minions that will most probably, that means that most probably these minions will have synergy with your deck, because you can summon one, or maybe you can even summon a Reno Jackson if you play this into singleton deck, so you will have 2 Reno Jackson. So how good is this? Pretty good. I think this card will definitely see some play. 4-star card. We will have a lot of play. We will see a lot of this card, so mark my word, this is pretty dangerous and important card. The stat is good. The effect is pretty strong one and we'll definitely see some play. So let's move to the next one. Next one we have, I want to apologize for the bad art, but this is exactly 1 minute after the stream is finished. So the art of the cards is just ripped off from somewhere. I downloaded from Hearthbound, so I apologize for this quickly. So let's move. This is a 2 mana mage spells. Spell Ancient Mysteries. Draw a secret from your deck. It costs 0. This is a 4-star card for me because it's pretty strong one. We have a similar card that was attached to a minion back in the day. It was 2 mana, 2-3 from a Journey to Un'Goro that draw a secret from your deck. It didn't discount though, but this one is draw specific secret from your deck and discount it by typically by 1, because you pay for this 2 mana and basically you play your secret just for 2 mana, which means that you are 1 mana plus with all these shenanigans. But it's very important because you can combo this 0 mana spell with other minions that have synergy in your deck with secret, so it's pretty strong one. If Secret Tempo Mage is viable this rotation, this card will definitely see a lot of play because it's pretty strong one and should not be underestimated. Also, it's a card that draws specific card from your deck, which means that it thins out your deck, so it's pretty nice one. So let's move to the next one. Next one we have, for some reason, Druid. This is Paladin card. This is Paladin card, but for some reason it have a Druid card borders, because maybe this is probably some kind of error or mistake by Hearthpwn, but it's possible because this is a very 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 fresh and freshly downloaded cards and art. So this is, guys, a Druid card. Subdue, set a minion's attack and health to 1 health to 1. So basically it's like a remover card. It can it's definitely will see play in slower decks. So it's a 3-star card for me because Paladin definitely need this kind of controlling tools. Paladin needs kind of removals, and this is something like removal, so for a big minion, so it's pretty fine card. 3-star for me, will definitely see some play in slower control Paladin deck. So let's move to the next one. This is the real Paladin card border, guys. You see it's a little bit more yellowish, not brown like this one, because this is from Druid. However, this is a 4-mana 4-2 Paladin card, Ancestral Guardian, Life Steal Reborn. This is pretty meh. I don't have much to say about this card. It's just a 2-star card. It has some synergy with Quest for Paladin, which is summon play 5 or 6 reborn minions, which is pretty okay, but it's not very powerful card, let's be honest. So I don't think this is a very interesting one. So it's a nice little card, but I don't think it will see much of a place outside the Quest Paladin. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have a pretty interesting and very good card, in my opinion, for Priest. 5-mana, 5-5, Sandhoof Water Bearer. At the end of your turn, restore 5 health to a damaged friendly character. So this is very, very good one. It can heal a specific minion if it's damaged. It can heal your hero if you need this. You can control this, like killing your minions or healing your minion for 2 if it's damaged. So you can guarantee that this effect will hit your main character. So this is a very very similar card, like Ragnaros the Light Lord for Paladin, which was released back in 2016 from the expansion Whispers of the Old Gods. It was a very very good legendary card. I apologize that I didn't have the time to download and show the art of the card, but it's basically exactly the same, but it cost 8 mana and heal 8 for the end of your turn, but with the exact same text. At the end of your turn, restore health to a damage friendly character, but it's 8, not 5, but it's exactly the same. This is a very very good card. This is a 4-star card for me. I don't see how this card will be played in Constructed, but this card is absolutely ridiculous in Arena, because it can heal your character, it can heal another minion, so you can retain the tempo and stuff like that. You can make trades and you can be sure that this card will heal the cards that you make the trade, so you can kill your smaller minions if you don't care for healing the smaller minions, for example, if they're 1-2 or 2-1s with 1 health and something like this. So this is pretty pretty powerful and very good strategic card. I like this type of card. Hearthstone need stable real card like this one, not just a casino cards that we used to see recently in most of the expansions. So pretty good one. I really love the card. Thanks Blizzard for creating such a strategic deep card that will probably never see any play in Constructed. I give my personal opinion here. I give this card a 4-star card because I love this card of I love this type of cards, but if you be realistic, probably this will not see much of Constructed play, which is kind of sorry, but It is what it is. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another priest card. 2 mana priest spell, Holy Ripple. Deal 1 damage to all enemies. Restore 1 health to all friendly characters. So this is a direct power creep to Arcane Blast for Mage, because Arcane Blast do exactly the same thing without the healing. So is that card any good in Mage now? No, no one actually in right mind play Arcane Blast, because it's not very useful against anything. But this card can actually be useful in Quest Priest, but outside of Quest Priest, did actually this kind of board clear do something? Not very much, but it can find some kind of utility in one way or another. So I give this card a 2-star card, because it's a pretty mediocre one, and I didn't see much utilization of this card. Yes, you can play this one with a Wild Pyromancer, which deal 1 damage for every spell that you play. So on round 5, you can play this. But why you can play this when you play Holy Nova and deal 2 damage is basically almost the same. But this is 2 card combo, so it's very clunky for me. It's something that I really don't like, so whatever. It's just that type of card that will probably see some kind of play, but not too much. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another 2 mana priest spell, Penance. Lifesteal, deal 3 damage to a minion. So this is a very similar card to a Warlock card, Dark Bomb. But Dark Bomb was a very, very old card from GVG. And basically it sees tons of play, but I think it's a little bit more powerful, because it can actually hit face, and this is sometimes very, very important. It can be used like finisher if you play some kind of hyper aggro deck. This one cannot heal, cannot use for finishing the game, because Blizzard are very, very careful. The Blizzard are very, very careful what cards they print. So deal 3 damage to a minion for 2 mana, it's pretty good. Lifesteal, it's pretty good because it has synergy with the quest. So I think this is a solid 3-star card, but nothing more than that. We'll definitely see some play in the first few weeks of the expansion, but more than that, I'm not sure. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another rogue card. 2 mana, Clever Disguise. Add 2 random spells from another class to your hand. So this is basically you complete your quest on round. You basically almost complete, half completing your quest on round 2. If you have this in your opening hand with coin, and 2 this and your second, you coin up this on round 1. You add 2 class from other class, it's the quest is half completed. Then you round 2, you play this one again and you finish the quest, and next round you can start using your very powerful 2 mana 3-2 weapon without taking damage when you are attacking. So is that good? That card is absolutely nuts, because it's says also spells, which means that you will have benefit from using cheap spells from other class, activate your combo and stuff like that. So it's pretty strong one. It's absolutely ridiculous card in a quest rogue. I think quest rogue will be nerfed at some point, because I didn't see the I see the game with the quest rogue, and the problem with the quest rogue is that didn't have any kind of strategy and any kind of finish. It's just super one-dimensional casino rogue style play with test, because you didn't have actually any win condition. It's just stupid, ridiculous kind of non-strategic gameplay that I don't like whatsoever. So this card is very good for me. It generates lots of value and have insane synergy with quest rogue, so it's pretty nice one. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have Shaman Elemental minion, 2 mana, 2/2, Sandstorm Elemental Battlecry, deal 1 damage to all enemy minions overload to 1. So if we talk about power creeping Arcane Blast, look at this one. So this is Arcane Blast attached to a 2/2 minions. Is that good? In that case, yes. And I want to pay attention to what this says. Deal 1 damage to all enemy minions. So this means that this can be used in aggressive decks. So your if you play Murlocs or some kind of super zoo deck, so or you can have some kind of totem, excuse me, you will not damage your totem will stay alive. So is this card good? Yeah, pretty good card. 4-star card, definitely will see tons of play in any zoo slash super hyper aggro zoo decks with shaman. So I think this is a pretty strong card right away. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have 7 mana, 3/4 Mogu Flesh Shaper. Mogu Flesh Shaper, rush cost 1 less for each minion on the battlefield. So basically this have the absolutely the same card text like Sea Giants, a neutral 10 mana cost giant with 8/8 in stats. So this one, it's a lot less in stat, but it's a way more cheaper. So usually you will want to play this when it's, let's say, it's one or two mana. Is that good for playing on 1 or 2 mana? Yeah, it's pretty good because it has rush, it can trade, so it's pretty good in aggro zoo deck, like I explained. So this is definitely a 4-star card. You'll see a tons of play because most often cases you will also play this for 0 mana, and we know that 0 mana minions is absolutely broken in any kind of shape and form in Hearthstone, and most probably in any other card game. So nothing more to say, is pure aggressive card that will see a tons of play. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have brand new legendary minion for shaman, 4 mana, 2/6 Vecina. While you are overloaded, your other minions have +2 attacks. So how can you utilize this? It's a little bit clunky in my opinion, because you need to set up a specific situations, you need to have minions on board, you need to set up an overlord situation, and you need to set up a situation in which you want to play this and basically finish the game. How hard is this to set up? Well, it's not very easy. I think this is a pretty much very weak card in my opinion. Maybe we'll see some play, it will see some utilization. Maybe I'm wrong about this one, but currently I don't see this card like much of a threat right now, because you usually don't want to play this card alone on board. You will probably want to set up a board situation with this. Probably this will see some play in Murloc decks, like a cheaper Bloodlust effect. Maybe it's almost like Bloodlust, but 1 mana cheaper. So maybe we'll see some play. I don't know, but currently I don't see this card like much. Don't see too much potential in this card. Anyway, so let's move to the next one. Next one, we have 0 mana totem, 0 mana shaman spell, Totem Search. Give your totem +2 attack. Wow, that's actually pretty interesting and powerful effect, because it's cost 0 mana, it's very easy to combo, and it have a insane synergy with the new weapon of shaman, which is, if my memory serves me well, axe splitter axe or something like this. I don't know, it's cutter axe or something like this. That anyway, it's the weapon. The text of the weapon is battle cry, summon a copy of all of your totems. So if you have a chance to summon a lot of totems, that's probably what you will do when you play shaman. Buff them with this and summon a copy of this shamans if you have 3, summon another 3, so basically you will have a lot of value. I think this is a 3 star card, we will definitely see some play, but will not broke the game, will not broke the game, I hope that will not broke the game, so it's pretty nice one. So let's move to the next one. Next one we have a Warlock Powerhouse, 3 mana, 4-5, wow, it's insane stats for 3 mana. We have similar stats to one card, 3 mana, 3-5. It was neutral turtle minion beast, which deal 5 damage to your hero when it's played. This is a little bit more demanding because whenever this attack deal 3 damage to your hero. Is that a problem for Warlock? Probably not too much, because Warlock didn't care too much about health, because Warlock will want to play ridiculous aggro zoo deck, tempo oriented deck. So this card is definitely a 3 star card. It's not something that is insane, but it's pretty strong one. So let's move to the next one. Next one we have Sinister Deal, Discover Lucky. This is a 4 star card, extremely powerful one, because it's discover, so you will finally have to choose from 3 luckies and will always pick the right one that you will need in this typical searching situation. So pretty strong one. Lucky generations is never a bad thing, so pretty good one, very strong card that we'll see a tons of play in every zoo aggro warlock deck. Move to the next one. We going to the neutral here. It's a lot of pack filler, 3 mana. So we have a neutral minion, 3-1, 1-1 desert hair battle cry, summon 2-1-1 desert hairs. So how good is this one? It's pay attention to this. This is not summon 2 copies of this minion, so it's strictly says that summon 2-1-1 desert. So this will not have synergy with hand buff mechanics. So you, even if this is 4-4 or 3-3, you will always summon a 1-1. So how good is this? Probably fine. But we now have similar cards that is a little bit stronger in this meta, for example, like Explodinator, which is also a mech, which have a lot of mech synergy. So I don't think this card is particularly strong. 1 star card for me, nothing too special now. Maybe we'll see some play in aggressive zoo token decks in the future, but not right now. We have absolutely ridiculous legendary neutral minion, Octosari, 8 mana, 8-8, death rattle deal, draw 8 cards. So this is absolutely ridiculous card in my opinion. I laugh so hard when I see this card in constructed, in the card revealed by Blizzard. It's such a funny one, and the animation is great, the presentation is great. The death rattle effect when it's actually pull out your card with one of the tentacles, it's absolutely ridiculously funny. Well done, Blizzard, for this one. So how good is this card? Let's be honest, it's not very good, to be honest. I really don't see much potential in this card. Maybe this card will see some kind of play in super zoo aggro deck, because we always struggle when we need to play zoo decks and we need to draw a card. But this is extremely slow effect, because it's a death rattle effect, it cost 8 mana and didn't absolutely nothing on board when it's played. For zoo decks I don't think this card will make the cut. For control decks, do you control decks really need to draw so many cards? Usually control decks and combo decks need to draw a lot of cards, but usually not that many, because this is a lot of cards and you can get in fatigue more quickly, you can overload your hand and discard important cards. So this card need to be played extremely carefully. It's a very powerful one, but need to be played extremely carefully. It's very susceptible to silence, so you need to be pay attention to this also. I personally give a 2-star card for this, because I didn't see much of an actual play plan with game plan with this card. I see it as a meme card, which is absolutely fantastic. The art design is great. So yeah, let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another neutral minion. 2 mana, 0/3 serpent egg tetrattle. Summon a 3/4 sea serpent, which is most probably beasts. Wow! 2 mana, 3/4 with delayed effect. This is ridiculous in any single token decks that can buff this card. I personally give this card a 4-star card because 2 mana, 3/4 is absolutely ridiculous, even when it's a little bit slow down. Yes, a little bit slow card, but pay attention, you can play this on round 2 and coin and kill it with lucky. Or no, maybe on round, okay, excuse me, on round 2 and kill it with Evil Genius from Warlock and summon this one and generate 2 luckies. Probably you will win the game because this is a ridiculously powerful card for 2 mana. We see a lot of X, but I think this is one of the most powerful one and it costs only 2 mana. So a pretty strong one. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have a pretty mediocre one. 3 mana, 2/2 neutral beast, golden scarab, battlecry, discover a 4-cost minion. Let's be honest, this will never see any play in constructed because it's way too slow and the stat is terrible, so no one will right mind me put this in his deck. So terrible card. Let's move to the next one. Next one, we have one of the most interesting and controversial legendary cards in the entire set, most probably. First of all, I want to say I love this card. Let's see what is the card. 2 mana, 3/2 neutral legendary minion. So it's a pretty good start. It's aggressively started card. Battlecry, if your deck has no duplicate, wish for the perfect card. So what this means? So what developers from Blizzard explained in the review stream is that actually this card generates 3 choices according to your specific board situation. So if you are in very bad situation, for example, if you are pushed to the wall with a lot of minions on the opponent board, for example, if opponent board is full of minions, it will generate chooses like Flame Strike, like Consecration, for example, Holy Nova, Blizzard or Twisting Nether on stuff like that. So if you need tempo, it will generate tempo cards or value oriented cards or whatever. It's just adaptive cards that will adapt considering on board situation. This is something that is programmed actually in the Blizzard for Hearthstone in specifically for this card. So it's, they say that it's kind of AI that look into collection in collection manager when you play this card, kind of try to find a situation on the board and give you the right choices. So this card is absolutely amazing and I will give 5-star to this card because design is absolutely incredible. It's very good card design, very great art, amazingly started card because this is intentionally a cheap legendary minion because you need to play this when you are on 8 or 9 or 10 mana because you need to play this and have a rest mana crystal to play spell and recover the game. It's a ridiculously good card in my opinion, but there is it's have one very very ridiculously big downside. If your deck has no duplicate, wish for 3 perfect card for the perfect card. So that's not a big deal. The big deal, it's a Bomb Warrior. Bomb Warrior will savagely counter every singleton decks in standard right now. So I don't think this card will shine. I don't think any of the explorers like Sir Finley, Renu Jackson, Elise and any other singleton explorers that we used to know will actually shine until the Bomb Warrior is died out next year, April 2020. So it's a amazingly incredible card. It's very flavorful, flavor card. It with great flavor. It's have amazing, amazing card animation. I will craft this on day one because it's such a brilliantly created and brilliant card. It's so great. It's strategic card. It's one of the strategic card that a random element is kind of controlled, but at some point it's not completely random. It has some kind of situation that you need to think twice before you play. Do you want to play this in early game so you can generate some kind of good tempo, or you will wait for this to for late game to clear the board if you play slow control deck? So it's a very, very flexible card, amazing design, but just because the Bomb Warrior exists, this card will not shine. I am absolutely sure about this, because control slash Bomb Warrior will counter this type of decks savagely. So I'm very sad about this, but it is what it is. I don't know why Blizzard decided to print this card just now. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another mediocre minion, 3 mana, 3-2, Reborn Candle Taker. So nothing too special. No one will actually play this in Constructed. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have 2 mana, 2-1 neutral minion, Bug Collector, Battlecry, summon a 1-1 Locust with Rush. So this is very similar to another card that we have. It's 2 star card because it will definitely see some play in Super Aggro Aggressive Hunter. It have synergy with Hunter, so why not? It's not too bad, but let's be honest, it's not something that you will die to put in your deck, to be honest. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have 2 mana, 1-2 Temple Berserker. Reborn has 2+2 attack while damage, another pack filler. Just a 1 star card. Terrible stats. No one will actually care to play this card because it can easily be killed, this one, and the one at a 1 health, it means nothing, so it can be removed with the new board clears that we see for Shaman and early board clears that we see for Shaman and Priest. So I don't think this card is particularly very interesting. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have Beaming Sidekick, neutral minion, 1 mana, 1-2 Battlecry, give a friendly minion +2 health. So this is a pretty strong one. In my opinion, it's probably will not see any play, or maybe we'll see some kind of limited play in Constructed, but this card is absolutely nuts in Arena because it's a 1 mana 1-2 that give +2 minion to other cards, which means that this card will be absolutely broken in Arena. I think this card is a 4 star card in Arena because if you play 2 cost minion on round 2, you can trade it with another minion on the enemy board and protect your board with because it will buff this one +2 on round 3 or even round 2 if you play with the coin, and you will getting out of control ridiculously because this card is so powerful in Arena. So a 4 star card for Arena and definitely 1 star card for Constructed, because probably we will never see this card in Constructed whatsoever, because let's be real, who actually care about healing minions in Arena? Not many people outside of Priest quest that will see some play maybe. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another neutral minion, 2 mana, 2-6 injured Tolvir, taunt, Battlecry, deal 3 damage to this minion. So this is a very similar effect to injured Blade Master, but injured Blade Master is 3 mana, 4-7, deal 3 damage to himself. Deal 4 damage to himself and it's turned to 4-3. So how good is this one? Well, it's pretty nice one. 2 mana, 2-3 with taunt. It's not too bad. Probably you will want even to play this in some ridiculously slow control decks and stall the game, because 2 mana, 2-3 with taunt is not that bad. So it's a 2 star card. It's have a ridiculously big synergy with Priest quest and with the previous card that we see that heal minion. But will you rely on this type of cards to complete the quests and to put such a low power level cards into your Constructed deck? I don't think so. But this card is a lot better than the other neutral minions that we have. So let's move to the next one. Actually, this is the last one, guys. So this is the last one. So this is almost 40 minute video. So I want to apologize this. But this is a lot of cards. Some of them very interesting. Some of them very mediocre. So This is the last Saviors of Uldum card review from me, unless I missed some of the cards. Maybe probably I missed some of the cards, or maybe this was not all the cards revealed. Maybe Blizzard will reveal the rest of the cards from the set tomorrow. Maybe they have some kind of leftovers that didn't have time to show on the stream. So thanks guys for watching, and I see you next time.